Hello, everybody. This is Jay Honcho. Looks like BLG Dinger is having a little trouble on Blistering Sands as the orange Zerg. And now we also have Shanky. This is game two of Group F. So we finally break from the ZVZ carnage and transition into what commonly is known as an Imba game. Of course, meaning imbalance in the Terran's favor for the plethora of options and strong units it has against Zerg early and mid-game. A lot of hard counters against Zerg, most notably the Marauder against Roaches, and the upgraded Pre-Igniter Hellions against everything but Roaches. So, and I guess Infestors too. But. I'm just going to sit and watch as the early game gets going. Not too much going on. Shanky putting up a wall. Very smart. Can't fault him for that. He's also going to be scouting as well with that SCV and dancing around until he can build a barracks. Trying to spam a button and get his APM up as we see him squarely in the lead of that graph as well. So, Dinger just going to be putting down a 12 pool. Interesting choice. And he's gas after we're not going to be able to instantly get speedlings, but on a map like this, it doesn't matter all that much. Shanky's SCV is in the base now, and Dinger does have a drone hiding in the planet side blocker. But Shanky not going to be seeing anything really outrageous right now. But still likes to move around and around. It's just a good psychological thing for your opponent to see you in their base. Now, he's just forcing a drone off the line. And we do see a tech lab, so possibly Reapers, as the orbital command slowly makes its way into existence. We do have Shanky moving his SCV to the natural, maybe fearing a fast expand, and he's going to be putting down a bunker. I cannot tell you how annoying this is. It's similar to a probe and a drone dancing here for some time, and then the probe just dropping a pylon. Very annoying. These Zerglings are not going to see it. They're scouting around inside the base for his SCV. While we do have a Reaper out, the second barracks is constructed. Let's just take a look at the income because their mule is out. Look, the Terran player, even though he is led by just one harvester, he does have a couple idle SCVs and he also has a couple things building, but yet his income is higher because of the mule. It instantly jumps like 140 income per minute every time the mule delivers. But the bunker is done, the Reaper, thinking a little bit differently, maybe going to go up the back door to harass a little bit. We do have a fair amount of Zerglings as well as a Spine Crawler going down for Dinger. And that could be an issue for the Reaper. We do have that bunker building SCV getting blocked by his own ramp. As we do have Marauders coming out. Marauders against anything but Roaches, not the best. They do 10 damage, are quite slow. And not really worth making. Barracks with a reactor going to be pumping out marines. We'll see if we have stim or shields or even concussive shells, as that hasn't been researched quite yet. And we also have a factory on the way. Kind of randomly placed supply depots. Doesn't really matter since they can be raised and lowered. The drone's still in the base for Dinger. Not going to do much with it. Right now we do have a Baneling nest going down, maybe to counter some of the bio that Shanky has. A reactor now on the factory as well, as a couple of marines get trained up. Still nothing coming there. Stim coming from the tech lab. And the orbital command pulling down another mule from orbit. And Oh, there's no overlap right now. But if you can briefly overlap your mules, your resources will spike. As we see now, he is already four harvesters ahead. Bad news for Dinger, as His opponent does have a large army as well. It looks like he's going to be moving out with some speedlings here. Seeing the bunker and Shanky reacts a little bit late, losing the bunker, all 100 minerals of it. Oh darn, that's not even the yield of a mule itself. We do have a lair on the way as well, and it looks like Dinger is going to be setting up shop right out front, morphing some banelings on the way, and Shanky is a little bit out of position, fearing the back door, which is the hardest part for Terran about this map. If you can put yourself in a position to make his army move from one place to the other, you can exploit the mobility issues the Terran has. So, BLG Dinger does have 7 banelings, or 8, is it? It is 7, and that wasn't an effective thing. It's almost maybe going to get Stimpak, but what he should have done was run up with a couple of speed. Looks like Shanky is going to repair that, and Dinger will retreat after that failed attack. A few banelings also waddling their way back. A Hydra Den as well, and Dinger has this issue where he's not building drones, and that's going to put him even further behind, even though he is grabbing his natural. It looks like Shanky might be doing the same, or he might just be pushing out. As that's a sizable force, this will roast an infinite number of speedlings. Shanky even going to be looking for maybe burrowed units, or just for any type of backstab over the line of sight blocker. So smart play by Shanky. Now, unfortunately, all these Zerglings with the head of the Hellions, and not much you can do there. Those banelings probably might do something. One going down, blowing up a Hellion, and these have to go all the way around and run into a Marauder meat shield. Marauder does have 4 kills, but don't forget. Oh, the cancel a little bit earlier than necessary, and now 3 Hydras and whatever's in production. 6 Zerglings are not going to be enough. They come one at a time, and they're just a big ball. With Stem, you might as well just call it place in water. Barely taking any damage from the queen. The spine crawler getting a little bit hot and heavy with some stuff. Hydra Dent unfortunately going down, and Dinger taps out. So, unorthodox play by Shanky. Very strong push early game, but the Marauders were kind of a question mark. Given time and more harvesters, Dinger could have been a problem with those Hydras. Needed to creep together his main is natural that he was getting, and make sure to watch your back door. That's one thing that Shanky didn't need to exploit, but could have very easily. So, that is game 2 of Group F. Coming up shortly, we do have Shanky versus LeFou. Stay tuned for that.